The police manhunt for an accused cop shooter is over. Gregg Thomas, who just today police named public enemy number one, surrendered to authorities without incident. Tonight, 11 News I-Team reporter David Collins is live at City Police Headquarters with the very latest developments on this investigation. David?
Well, according to Commissioner Batts, shortly after we broadcast his comments calling Thomas a coward and strongly urging to turn himself in, he showed up at the Central District Police Station. The manhunt is over. 34-year-old Gregg Thomas surrendered without incident.
One less suspect. One less killer on the streets of Baltimore.
Police identified Thomas as the one who ambushed City Police Sergeant Keith McNeil. Investigators say it happened Friday evening in the 1900 block of Bel Air Road as McNeil sat in his personal vehicle and in civilian clothes. Detectives determined he had been running personal errands. Sergeant McNeil is listed in critical condition, recovering from multiple gunshot wounds.
We don't know the motive. I don't know why you will walk up to someone in a car and shoot them multiple times. All I can say is that I do thank God that my officer is still alive. I do thank God that his family will not be without a husband or a dad.
McNeil's wife, Danielle, issued a statement thanking police. Quote, I appreciate everyone's prayers, support, and the long hours you put in to catch the man who shot Keith. I love all of you just as much as you have showed your love for Keith, end quote. Sergeant McNeil is a 19-year veteran of the police force, assigned to an administrative position in Eastern District. Commissioner Batts visited with him in the hospital.
As we shared with him what we were doing, after talking to his wonderful bride, his high school sweetheart, he gave a thumbs up. Very courageous man, very honorable man, and a very popular employee.
Thomas, whom city police designated as public enemy number one, had been the focus of a dragnet that involved the state police, officers from surrounding jurisdictions, and two federal agencies. Police considered Thomas armed and dangerous. Court records indicate he has a violent criminal history that includes serving time for a 2003 murder. Thomas's mother and sister also under arrest for outstanding warrants for drug charges. His brother Lamont, now back in police custody, was busted Wednesday for drug running. His mom, who lives in public housing, bailed him out. Police wonder where she got all that money.
I'm sure the Internal Revenue is going to want to know the answers to that.
Commissioner Batts says detectives are retracing Thomas's steps, and if they determine someone helped him, they too will face charges. Reporting live from the Bishop Robinson City Police Headquarters building downtown, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.